When I saw that Cotton Reboot was coming out this week, I immediately knew that I needed to post a Game Over episode comparing the brand new rebooted narrative with the quirky story we saw in the 1991 original. I mean, what better way is there to get you in the mood for the return of a shoot 'em up classic? Well, as it turns out, there was one big problem with that plan. You see, Cotton Reboot is not a reboot. As I mentioned numerous times in my review, it's actually a remake of the original, complete with the same story, cinemas, and ending. Sure, everything's been redrawn for the remake, but the fact still remains that whatever I say about the early 90s arcade game is gonna apply to Cotton Reboot. So heed my words and turn back now if you don't want to know what happens next, because today we're gonna spoil the story and ending for Cotton Fantastic Night Dreams. This is Game Over, the early years. Cotton starts out like any other fantasy game. The once colorful world has been completely covered in darkness, bringing with it evil monsters and a real sense of dread. But you know who doesn't care about any of that? Yeah, it's Cotton, a young, self-absorbed witch who cares more about her candy than being a hero. This is something that a tiny fairy named Silk learns the hard way when she tries to recruit Cotton to help her save Fairyland. Obviously, this tactic doesn't work, but just as the witch starts walking off, Silk reveals that there might be a way to earn a special kind of Willow's candy. All Cotton needs to do is help. With candy on the line, the unlikely duo heads off for an adventure to defeat evil. This starts with a battle to retake the local village, which ends with a fight against this multi-headed statue that floats around the screen shooting out rocks. This is where we find our first piece of Willow's candy, but not so fast. Before Cotton can get her lips on that tasty treat, Silk steals it away and reveals that in order to defeat evil, they're gonna need to collect 7 different colored candies and combine them together. This will turn them into a great big Willows, which immediately gets Cotton back on board. Our next stop is the nearby graveyard, where the team fights off the Grim Reaper for another piece of that delicious Willows candy. Cotton is still drooling over those delectable delights, but at least for now, she's holding strong. She understands that she has to fly up the side of a mountain and enter the castle because she knows that the reptilian guard holds the third piece of candy. It's at this point where Cotton has gone from being a begrudging hero to actually taking this adventure seriously. Not that she has much of a choice, seeing as she's already deep in the heart of the castle. And this is not just any old castle, but rather one with an evil sphinx at the end. A nude one. Thankfully, the sphinx is no trouble for Cotton, and she collects her 4th piece of candy. You know, she's really come a long way since starting this journey, and we're at the point now where even the narrator is rooting her on. Everybody wants to see Cotton succeed. But even with all that encouragement, there are signs that our hero is starting to break. The further into the castle she gets, the more she's thinking about eating those mouth-watering munchies. It's especially bad after she defeats the boss and finds the 6th piece of candy. This is where Cotton finally breaks, forcing Silk to do everything in her power to keep that Willow safe. With only one more candy left to go, it's anybody's guess if this team will be able to keep it together long enough to save Fairyland. For now, the mission is simple. Cotton needs to fly through the erupting volcano and slay the dragon. That's it. Just get to the dragon, collect the 7th candy, combine them, and save the day. That's Cotton's only job. Well, as it turns out, slaying the dragon was the easy part. Resisting that candy, on the other hand, proved to be impossible for Cotton, who gobbles up that delicious cherry treat. Yum! Unfortunately, this turns out to be a terrible decision. With only 6 candies, Cotton won't be able to complete her quest. And it's actually worse than that, because not having enough candies has triggered a fight against a massive and extremely pissed off fairy. Realizing that she screwed up, Cotton gets back in the game, defeats that evil fairy, and hopes for the best. And at long last, this is what happens next. You know, this is a sweet ending. Sure, Silk had to lie about getting a great big candy, but I like how Cotton grew up over the course of the adventure and eventually got her sweet snacks. And best of all, the ending sets up future adventures because now Silk knows how to convince Cotton to do just about anything. But even with this setup, the sad reality is that Western gamers never got a chance to go on these new adventures. Games like Cotton 100% and Cotton 2 Magical Night Dreams all seem to have equally good cinemas and endings, but they were never translated for an English-speaking audience. That's a shame, because the games are great and the stories look like they're a whole lot of fun. I mean, if they're anything like this first Cotton game, then I can't wait to see what happens next. Just give me that candy! Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Game Over, The Early Years. If you liked what you saw here, then you should know that we post new episodes almost every week. Now, here's the question I have for you. What classic shoot-'em-up needs to be brought back? It can be with a remake, or a reboot, or sequel, spin-off, I honestly don't care. What I want to know is if there's a classic shooter that you want to see return in one form or another. Ooh, can't wait to see your picks in the comments below. In other news, we'll be wrapping up a full week of shooters by counting down Electronic Gaming Monthly's best reviewed shoot-'em-ups of all time. That sounds good to you, then I strongly recommend you click that subscribe button and support what we're doing here. Until then.